I am Rolf Kühnecke. I'm Professor of Economics of Infrastructures at Delft University of Technology. In this module, I will outline some ideas about the coherence between technology and institutions. And this is the plan. First, I will refer to the case of e-charging infrastructures. Then I will elaborate on this idea of coherence between technology and institutions. And finally, I will draw some conclusions. The case of e-charging infrastructures in the Netherlands is a very interesting one, as I already mentioned in an earlier module. The Netherlands has one of the most dense e-charging infrastructures worldwide. The Dutch government very much trusts on the so-called market model. It tries to stimulate private sector initiatives. In this context, we have to be aware that private actors can choose for different technological and institutional means for the development of this e-charging infrastructure. And this is also the topic of this module. What is the possible interrelatedness between different institutional and technological choices with respect to the e-charging infrastructure? The e-charging infrastructure requires specific technological and institutional means. From a technological perspective, certain charging technologies are necessary, for instance, with respect to home charging or DC fast charging. From an institutional perspective, the charging connectors, there might be specific standards that can be used with different providers of e-charging facilities, and also payment settlement agreements are very important in this respect. Are you always able to pay for the electricity you charge for your car for different providers? So these institutions and technologies are very interrelated. So refer to this example here presented in this picture. If you drive by car to a shopping mall and you want to charge your car, you need to make sure that you have the correct plug to connect to this provider to get your electricity. And you also may have to make sure that you are able to pay for the electricity you get. And this is something which is not common sense. So institutions and technology are interrelated, and the technological and institutional coordination need to be coherent to meet societal expectations. So if you drive with your car to a shopping mall and you are not able to pay for the electricity because there are no agreements between the different providers of payments, this will be a situation which is not attractive for the users of electric cars. So let's elaborate this a little bit more in detail with respect to the example of the safeguarding of critical functions. Like in any other infrastructural systems, also with respect to e-charging facilities, we can identify four critical functions that are essential for providing e-charging services. And these four functions are called interoperability, interconnection, capacity management, and system management. Interoperability is about the use of these facilities and the usability of these facilities between different service providers. Interconnection is related to the distribution of e-charging stations in space, for instance, throughout Europe, not only throughout a certain part of the country or the country, but perhaps even internationally. Capacity management is about the availability of e-charging capacity and time. So if you drive by car to a shopping mall, you want to use this charging pole directly and not waiting for an hour and then charging your car for another hour. That would take too much time. So you would be willing to have this facility available if you need it. And that's the critical function of capacity management. And system management is related to the availability of the expected e-charging services. So if you drive to an e-charging pole, which provides fast charging facilities, you want to be sure that these facilities are provided as you want. So these critical functions can be used to demonstrate the coherence between institutions and technology. The idea is that the safeguarding of critical functions is related to the technology and institutions of e-charging infrastructures. And if these critical functions are not safeguarded, neither technically nor institutionally, the societal performance of these e-charging facilities will be very much inferior. So safeguarding this critical function is an issue of technology and an issue of institutional arrangements. Coherence is the related to the comparability of the technical and institutional means for safeguarding critical functions. And I will elaborate this based on two examples in the following. And as already mentioned, this notion of coherence is important to meet societal expectations. So let's elaborate these ideas a little bit more in detail based on two examples with respect to e-charging facilities. Let's first elaborate the example of interoperability. A very exciting idea with respect to interoperability of e-charging facilities is the so-called e-roaming. Car owners can charge at any station with a single ID. So there is no difference which provider you choose. You can always use your ID, your payment facilities, your plug to use these facilities wherever you want with each possible provider. This requires open standards for settling of payments. And in this respect, we would expect certain institutional arrangements that would support these open standards. But in reality, as we see it now, e-charging operators often rely on proprietary payment technology. And in this respect, this payment technology would not be in coherence with these ideas of e-roaming. The case of the Netherlands is very interesting in this respect. The Netherlands applied some regulations in which all public charging points are required to use a single ID. So this regulatory requirements of the Netherlands really influences the technological choices these operators of these charging pool make. And in that respect, we would have established coherence between these institutions to enable e-roaming and the technology that is required to do it. So in this case of the Netherlands, in this case of coherence, we would expect superior societal and economic performance of the e-charging infrastructures compared to a situation in which these charging operators rely on different fragmented proprietary payment technologies. The second example in this respect is capacity management. And capacity management now in a little bit broader context. Technically, many e-charging stations are operated without taking public grid effects into consideration. And this might in future be a problem, especially with respect to fast DC charging. These fast DC charging stations really take a lot of power from these public grids. And there might be a problem because at peak hours, the public network might not be equipped to technically meet demand, especially with respect to fast charging facilities. So there is a problem. So that might also relate in result in possible outages. So if more power is demanded than would be available through the public grid, this charging pole would not work, or even worse, the public network would have a blackout. So this would be a case of incoherence, because there would be a lack of institutional arrangements for data exchange between the public network provider and the e-charging operator. So to have a coherent situation, we would need some institutional arrangements to exchange the relevant data of the use of the e-charging facility and the status of the public network between the network operator and the e-charging operator. So this idea of coherence between institutions and technologies is shortly outlined in this figure. At the top part, we see what is here called system-relevant functions, or what I refer to here as critical functions. These are the critical functions of interoperability, interconnection, capacity management, of system management. And as indicated by the two arrows, these critical functions need to be facilitated as well in a technical sense as in an institutional sense. And these coordination, these technical coordination and the institutional coordination, as I outlined in my examples, need to reinforce itself. And that is what we call degree of coherence. So if there is coherence between the technical coordination and the institutional coordination, we would expect a superior infrastructure performance with respect to economic, social, or even technical system integrity. In the case of incoherence, we would expect problems in that respect. So let's conclude. We illustrated in this lecture that technology and institutions of e-charging infrastructures are strongly related, and we have to take this interrelation into considerations when designing and developing these e-charging infrastructures. We outlined the idea of four critical functions that are essential for assessing the societal performance of e-charging infrastructures. And we stated and also illustrated that coherence between institutions and technology is an important condition for the successful development of e-charging infrastructures.